What is up, everybody? It's Hobbs here, back with you with your Wild Eye Wednesday review. This is a Wild and Extreme line. And today we're going to focus on the movie Lycanimator. It is unrated. This film had a budget of $3,500, which is very small. A small budget. The quality of the film that you got there. This is a 2018 release. That's actually a pretty good depiction of the werewolf you would see. Beware the big bad slimy wolf. And this is very true. The slimy wolf, he does get slimy and he does get very green. So fortunately this became destroyed in the mail as I ordered this from the MVD sale, but it's all good. Let's talk about this awesome movie. What you have here is you have a group of kids that are going to this house to party, kick back, cut back, do what kids do, drink, party, bump uglies, you know, all of those things. Well, there's already kids there at this place that are going to, and there's some history in the home that they're going to, some history about some of the legends in the area and things like that. By the way, you also get a special appearance by Todd Sheets in this film. Todd Sheets is a legend, in my opinion, in independent horror and horror in general. I have a lot of his films there in the very back. So Todd Sheets, shout out to Todd Sheets on this as well. And essentially what happens is they're running out of booze to party with. So out of peer pressure, one of them has to be sent to the cellar to get the booze. The one thing you do not want to do, you do not want to go in the cellar, as there is a man trying to stop the kids from even going to the house. And that man is also trying to convince them, look, just don't go over there. Stay here. You know, you don't want to do it. But they end up doing it, of course. Of course, you're going to do that when you're a kid. You're going to rebel and you're going to go to the house. And inside the cellar, there is this serum. And a little bit of a scuffle breaks out. One of the kids ends up drinking the serum and becoming the wolf. The wolf alien type creature, slimy wolf that we talk about here. And all hell breaks loose. People are starting to get picked off. The main character who is trying to get the kids to stop and not go to the house ends up showing up. And I'm not going to say what happens from there because I don't want to spoil it. I will put this, there is a reference to the movie Predator. I'm not for sure if anybody caught that. I've not seen that in people's reviews, but there is a really, really nice reference to the movie Predator in this. And chaos ensues at the house with a wolf on the loose. Lycanimator. What are my thoughts on this film? You know, I know they had a lot of parts that they added. I know it's only an hour-long film. They had a lot of fillers. This is number 38 on the Wild Eye Extreme line. They did have a lot of fillers in this. You could tell there were scenes that were cropped in or added in, for sure. I do know the one character everybody wanted to have killed was the blonde-haired dude. People were ready for him to die in the first 5 minutes of the film. That only means that he sold it well. So, I mean, you know, you have characters that you root for. You have characters that you want to survive. But in this film, you also have characters that you just hope to get picked off as early as possible. So that is one thing you notice in the film right away. There's just a tad bit of nudity in the film. I think for a film like this, I think I would have added more, to be honest with you, more than that was there. I'm not like a perv or anything, but for this particular type of film, I think you could have added more. It's the Wild Eye Raw and Extreme line, right? So I wouldn't have put this up there with Spanish Chainsaw Massacre or, you know, Streets Run Red, things like that, but it was a very fun film. I had a blast with it. I was laughing out loud majority of the time during the film. I did like the soundtrack to the film, all of the music. It's kind of like an 80s throwback almost like Return of the Living Dead-ish a little bit. But yeah, definitely go check out Lycanimator. If you are a fan of werewolf movies, now you're not going to get the same type of wolf. I'm just throwing it out there. It's a little bit different, but I liked it because it was different. They dared to be different. And that's what was cool about the film. Definitely worth a watch. Definitely worth a weekend watch if you can do it. But anyways, no real drawbacks to the film other than the parts that were in and out of the film. I wish that would have been a little bit different, but you know, when things are kind of all over the place a little bit, you kind of want more of a pieced together film. But the budget was $3,500. They did a great job, guys. Go check out Lycanimator. Do not go in the cellar and don't drink the serum. All right, guys. Catch up with you later. This is Hobbs. See you tomorrow on 8 Questions with Half Cheetah Review. We are interviewing Courtney Gaines today. That's right. Courtney Gaines on 8 Questions with Cheetah. We'll see you on the midnight hour this weekend. Sunday nights at 10 p.m. This is Hobbs.